everyone, and welcome to Footy Talks in association with Benjamin Moore, whose stores are all open right now for you to go to. Great to see you, Richie. First of all, I want to just get your thoughts on how you're feeling right now. There, a couple of days out from the game, you've been down there since Monday. There's been a lot said about what life is like within the bubble. Give the TFC fans listening a taste of what it's like down there for you guys in Orlando.
Thank you guys for having me, first and foremost. But it's been pretty good. We're making the most of it amongst the guys here on our team. We're staying amongst each other, trying to keep guys busy, and a lot of training, a lot of banter, and it's good to be back with the guys again. So we're trying to make the most out of a very odd and difficult situation right now.
Do you feel safe?
Yeah, for the most part, I think all of us feel pretty safe. There were some concerns definitely as a group before coming here, and with all the news you guys were hearing, we were hearing as well, coming out of the bubble, obviously that's something to raise concerns amongst all of us. So some of us have families, and even if you don't have families, it's something you think about. You don't want to go somewhere blindly and not know what you're being hit with. So since coming down here, I think it's been pretty safe, and we feel pretty comfortable for the most part, but there's definitely still safety precautions that we're all looking after and doing.
Richie, let's talk about those precautions a little bit then, if you don't mind. Can you just maybe explain to some of the TFC fans what that situation is like? Because I know there's league-wide protocols, and some clubs have been even taking it even further. Is it just a floor that you're sticking to? How's that looking right now in that hotel for you guys?
Yeah. We're all on, our entire team is on one floor, and we don't share with anyone else, so that's nice. So we only see ourselves and anything we need in terms of from the hotel. It's put outside our door, and then we go and get it from there. So no one's really coming in and out of your rooms or anything like that. And, obviously wearing masks everywhere we go. And yeah, it's been good in that from that standpoint. And then we also have credentials that we wear to make sure that you're an actual TFC player on this floor or in and around the building. So those are some of the precautions. And, the biggest thing is just a lot of washing your hands, a lot of hand sanitizing, and just mask everywhere you go.
Richie, let's talk about some things on the field. How are you feeling personally, first and foremost? And how do you think the guys are looking as a group in terms of fitness and cohesion, I guess? You know, are you getting there, or do you still feel that you've got a bit to go before you are up anywhere near 100%?
Yeah, I feel pretty good, actually. I think these having Canada and Toronto open up pretty quickly in terms of training basis, I think we got touches in together pretty quickly, so I think that's pretty good, and I think we have a very good group, so it didn't take long for guys to gel again. So these trainings are back to being very competitive, guys neck to neck with each other for positions and whatnot, so it's been good, and I personally feel good. All the guys look really good. Everyone looks really sharp. Everyone's looking to compete and very excited for this first game.
With the first game being a 9 a.m. kickoff, is that the time that you've been training during this week, or has it changed? I know everybody, obviously there's a lot of fields at Disney, but all 26 or 24 teams now are there with different training slots they're given each week. How does it work? Do you have the same time every day, or does it keep changing day by day?
No, we're all currently going off the basis of what time we play the first game at. So we're training in and around that time a little bit earlier, because we'd be warming up during that time. So we're going in about just after 8. So we're seeing what the weather is going to be like, what the field's going to be like around that time. So we've tried to adjust it as best as possible so we can be ready for the game around obviously a very odd 9 a.m. kickoff game.
Yeah, is that going to impact it in a bigger way than playing at 8:30 or even 10:30 at night? I heard one player say that actually, although it's hotter in the morning, 9 a.m. for an East Coast player is actually better than playing at 10:30 at night in that time slot, because you're up early usually training around 10 on a regular day, and you don't usually stay up till 10:30 at night training or playing games in the regular run of things.
Yeah, I'd have to agree with that. I think I'd rather, I think 9 a.m. might be a little bit better than 10:30, but obviously a 7 or 8 p.m. kickoff would be ideal, but these are one of the difficult things that we have to face being here with so many teams, and obviously working around the schedule of Orlando and Florida. It rained in every other hour, it feels like, so we have to I think the league's done that so we can get games in proper and not have any stoppages.
Richie, it's been a good start to the tournament. We've been doing the games here on TSN. All the games are live on TSN. And obviously we saw the opening night, which is a good win for Orlando with a last second goal by Nani. But I want to ask you about your involvement about that. Obviously, that was an incredible night for Major League Soccer. You know, incredibly powerful to see, you know, what you guys were able to deliver. Justin Morrow addressed it on ESPN, but I'd love to hear your thoughts about it, being involved in that wonderful ceremony, so to speak. And also, since we last had you on, and I know when I had a conversation with you on TSN, there was this desire from a lot of you guys collectively to come together and form something. And subsequently, now the Black Players for Change have come together. Maybe a couple of part questions, but how was that the other night, and how is that unity come together very quickly amongst the players?
Yeah, I mean, honestly, it was incredible. That it was such a powerful statement put across the league, the country, the world. It was, I think it was very well done. And hats off, obviously, to Justin for starting this entire thing and then bringing guys in along the way. And, you know, like you said, there's guys from 24 out of the 26 teams in the league, which, you know, we're used to competing against each other and not necessarily hating each other, but that's your opponent on the day. So those aren't my friends normally or anything like that. But to be together with the entire black pool of players in the MLS was really, really special. I think it just shows how unified everyone is to fight this fight right now. And it's it was powerful. I was taken away by how powerful it even was when nothing was being said. We were silent and just with our fists up, and it was such a strong statement. And I know a lot of the guys felt the exact same way. And for me, this is just the beginning of something that's bigger and better to come from all the black players in this league. And not only the black players, now our other teammates who are also very supportive of it, our coaches, GMs, owners, people from the outside, whatever else it might be. This is just a baby step for what this organization wants to do moving forward.
Richie, if you can, please take us back to the formation of this group and I guess your pride and admiration in your teammate Justin Morrow for leading it. And a follow-up to that I'd like to ask is, you know, we're hearing some initiatives around, you know, this whole tournament this week, or a few weeks, I should say, in Orlando. If you can give us a glimpse into anything that you know might be coming up, some player appearances and other things that are going to be around the movement and to try and see some real change.
To be honest with you, I haven't heard much. I know we'll probably get together as the entire player pool again. Hopefully, not all of us, but maybe the leaders from every team to discuss furthermore what we'll do. But yeah, I mean, I'll speak on Justin on a bit, on Justin's piece for a bit. What he's done and what he's created is so special. And I don't know if you guys saw him on TV, but you could see it meant the world to him, and it meant the world to the rest of us there with him. Even getting off that field, you know, we came back to our teams and all the guys were like, wow, that was super powerful. Just stuff of that nature. But like to answer your question in terms of appearances and stuff like that, I definitely see, I don't know about appearances, but I definitely see a lot more coming maybe in the near future to have to do with this whole organization, because I think that was a very good first step and a way for us to put our foot in the door or make ourselves known, I could say. And then now it's about, you know, just constantly applying that pressure to show people this is what this group is about, and we are here for change, for unity, and to be together as one, not only as black players, but everyone of all different races, colors, backgrounds, and whatnot.
That was an image on the opening night of MLS's back that went all around the world. I saw that covered globally for this league. It was a huge moment. In fact, a few people have said, who've been around the league a long time, if you mention the top five iconic moments in Major League Soccer, that's right up there with some of the incredible things that have happened in the last 25 years on and off the pitch. And then there was another one last night in the game we were covering. We got told just as the game was starting, Thierry Henry was going to kneel for the first 8 minutes and 46 seconds of the game in tribute to George Floyd, and obviously to highlight Black Lives Matter. And this morning I went on, TSN had put a video clip out of that, and I'd seen someone retweet it from England, and I went on and looked, and there were 600,000 video views of Thierry Henry getting back to his feet at 8:46 in that game. And again, a moment where the whole world is watching right now, and Major League Soccer has taken on, whether with your group or with individuals making decisions, and like Philadelphia did yesterday, taken on that responsibility of promoting this and making sure that everybody knows what needs to be said, what needs to be done. And I thought that was, like from Thierry Henry last night, someone, I mean, who you must respect in the game, Richie, to see him doing that and being involved was an incredible moment.
Yeah, that was huge. I was watching the game as well. So to see the commentators, I was watching on TSN actually, so it was you lot. So hearing you guys speak about it and all of it, it was good because, yeah, Thierry Henry is obviously such a world-renowned player and everyone knows how class he is on the field. But for him to do that, that's something people are going to remember about him for the rest of his life. They're not going to remember the goals and the appearances and all the trophies.
And the handballs.
Exactly. But people are going to remember that moment that he was kneeling for 8 minutes and 46 seconds. That's such a powerful stance coming from someone like that. Again, all the things that he's done in his career, for him to do that, to show that he's together and in this fight, and, you know, he's putting himself in the shoes of every single other black person in this country and in this world, means it's a strong stance for him. And I know a lot of guys really, really appreciate it. So I was very happy to see him do something like that, because obviously with him being who he is, he could have got a lot of backfire for it as well, but he didn't care and he did it anyway. So that was pretty powerful from him.
Richie, can I ask you about your GM, Ali Curtis, actually? While I'm thinking about it, congratulations on your contract extension. That's with, since we had you on last time, they deserve that. I know it only got recently announced, but you've had it for a while, but congrats on that, down to your hard work. But Ali Curtis stood there as well with you guys next to his brothers the other night. And I know it's a lot of people talk about the players, but highlighted in this whole process is sometimes the lack of diversity in the executive positions. Maybe you can just speak to that a little bit, if you don't mind, about how involved Ali's been. I know he was very heavily involved in the video, the powerful video the club put out a couple of days ago as well. So how much as a role has he played in all of this throughout this process?
Yeah, he was huge as well. He was doing a lot of stuff in terms of on the club front, and he really wanted to nip this in the bud and get it done properly. So again, a big thank you to him as well, because he's been super involved as a team. We had several Zoom calls with Ali and the team, speaking about ways that we can help educate ourselves and do something for people and the community and whatnot. So that was a good stance he also showed, and it's been good. And now also I feel very fortunate to be playing under one of two, I think, black GMs in the entire league. So it's a good thing for him to have. And now that he's there and this whole movement's happening, I hope to one day soon in the near future see more than just Ali Curtis as a black GM in this league. And there's, you know, several across the board on many different teams. So it's definitely, you know, again, he's a guy that could maybe things could be portrayed wrongly for him speaking his mind because of the position that he holds. But again, he's speaking freely and he's being respectful, but he's speaking his mind. So it's also a very strong stance from him, and it shows the courage that he has to fight this fight and fight for what's right now.
Richie, it's been an incredible 4 months, but you are now 48 hours out from stepping back on the pitch in a competitive game with your teammates. And I just know from being alongside KJ for the opening game into Miami Orlando on Wednesday, and then Stevie last night in the broadcast booth, it was so nice just to feel normal again after having been at home and had to fight through everything and wondering whether or not the league would be back, if we'd get to see soccer games again. It's as normal as we've felt in months. So when you step over that line at 9 a.m. Or when you arrive at the stadium, just as you would do on a normal match day, or you wake up at 5 a.m. for your pre-match pasta, as it's going to be on Sunday, what do you think that feeling is going to be like there for you and the rest of the players to finally be back out there in what is going to be a competitive game?
Yeah, it's gonna feel special for sure, because I know a lot of us have been itching to get back on the pitch and just playing these inter-squad games that we've been having in Toronto before arriving here. Those almost felt somewhat real, and we're playing at BMO and whatnot. So it was nice, but now to be playing a competitive game against another opponent is going to be big for us. And not all of us are looking forward to this game. Even though it is at 9 a.m., like you said, and we'll be waking up a little bit earlier, everyone is buzzing for the game. We want to get the ball rolling, and we want to obviously start on a very good on the front foot. And hopefully this performance kickstarts a series of very good games for us here down in Orlando. And whenever us Toronto C as a team step on the pitch, we are obviously trying to win it all. So I hope this game puts us in the right position to do so.
Thanks for your time, Richie. Really appreciate it. And maybe another goal scoring performance against DC from you.
Thank you. I appreciate it. And I hope so.
Thanks, Richie. Always a pleasure. Be safe.
I think we're going to be back Monday with another Footy Talks. We'll try and do 2 days before every TFC game throughout this tournament. But for now, thanks to everyone for being with us. Thanks for watching. And we'll see you bright and early Sunday morning. Get the breakfast ready. Breakfast with the Reds on Sunday. This was Footy Talks with Benjamin Moore.